P.E. Federal Reserve V is not ABANK.
What you mean, E. Federal FESERV is not ABANK?
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense. I mean, it's called the Federal Reserve Bank.
You guys are young, and so please pardon me if it sounds like I skipped the couple of steps. I'm used to talking to older individuals.
What's age got to do with it?
You know, it sounds like you think you are better than us.
How could I think you're better than me or I'm better than you? All I said was, the Federal Reserve is not a bank, and you act like you are surprised. And then I said I'm not used to talking to younger individuals, because older individuals already know this information. Look, this has been common knowledge since they formed the Federal Reserve Bank. It's nothing but a private institution. They don't actually do any banking in the normal sense of the word. But yet, they're still called a bank. Why?
Jay, do you really think we ought to sit here and listen to this? I mean, he kind of sounds senile. He's probably got dementia or Alzheimer's or something.
I think we should hear him out, because, come to think about it, what person do you know banks at the Federal Reserve?
I watch YouTube all the time, and there's all kind of people talking about doing that, but I ain't never heard of anyone actually doing it. Okay, we'll hear what you have to say.
Thank you. The Federal Reserve Banks, established by the Federal Reserve Act of 1913, 38 Stat. 251, operate within the Federal Reserve System. These banks perform essential banking functions, such as holding reserves for member banks, providing payment services, and implementing monetary policy. They are called banks due to their banking activities, which include accepting deposits from member institutions and making loans, often referred to as discount lending. It authorized them to perform central banking functions, including receiving deposits and extending credit. So it is because they receive deposits and issue loans that they are considered a bank. But it is neither federal nor any part of the government. It is a private corporation.
Who gives it the right? If the Federal Reserve is not a part of the federal government and they are a private corporation, how do they get to determine what the monetary policy is?
Now, that's the question that follows the statement, the Federal Reserve Bank is not a bank.
Well, what's the answer to the question?
I see you're impatient, which means this conversation will not last very long.
I'm not impatient. I just don't have time for wordplay and word games.
Lewis, would you stop and let him explain?
Thank you, my dear.
That sounds creepy.
Young man, I've had it with you. I don't have patience, especially the type of patience that would require me to tolerate your disrespect, so I'm removing you from this conversation.
You going to remove me who you think you are? You can't remove me.
I apologize, but your question was the correct question. Why does the Federal Reserve have so much power if they're just simply a private corporation? It's because they made a private deal with the United States, a deal that we are not privy to know the details of. There are many theories, including those of Jekyll Island, but again, those are all theories. The truth is, we simply don't know.
Wait, what can we do? If they are a private corporation, how do we survive? If they control the money as a private corporation, that means the money truly is valueless?
Okay, calm down, he's gone. And in just a little bit, I'll explain some of the things that you can do, because you're not powerless. There are some trade-offs written in the law that helps you. First, Federal Reserve notes are not money as defined by the Constitution. But we are not concerned about definitions. We are concerned about access. And I'm about to explain to you how to access Federal Reserve notes according to the law. You go to the bank and apply for a loan. And you bring all the standard paperwork that they asked for, but you also bring additional paperwork, such as Federal Reserve Operating Circular 10 Appendix 3. You don't fill out every line. You don't fill out every section. The sections that you fill out will be the authorization sections. Everything else is for the bank to fill out. You tell them that you're applying for a loan and that you're following the Federal Reserve Act, and you need to know what the proper procedures aside from those that are in Federal Reserve Operating Circular 10 and Section 400 and one of Title IV of the Federal Reserve Act subsection 18 paragraph number 6 as amended.
That's a whole lot. I don't think I'll be able to remember all that.
I thought you said you wanted a loan and access the Federal Reserve notes. Well, you will have to follow their rules, their policies, their procedures. So that means you will have to go over Federal Reserve Operating Circular 10 Appendix 3. This is necessary. Look, everyone, the law is not complicated. It's actually rather simple. The Federal Reserve Act was created to invent the Federal Reserve Bank. The Federal Reserve Board of Governors in the Federal Reserve Board is a private corporation that has subsidiaries, 12 major corporations known as the Federal Reserve Banks, and thousands of subsidiary, minor corporations known as the member banks, and several mediocre corporations known as financial institutions. But they all follow the same law, the Federal Reserve Act. It is the Federal Reserve Act that says that your promissory notes and your bills of exchanges are at par with Federal Reserve notes. In the Federal Reserve, notes are construed and considered as legal tender. Then what does that make your instruments? The key is understanding tax credits. Every debt is a business expense because we only engage in business when incurring debts. There is no such thing as a private debt, because a private debt can only be incurred by a private business. That's why the bankruptcy code calls it a personal debt, applying it to your person. You have to transfer the debt to your fiction or non-person. By transferring the debt to the sole proprietorship, you can now write it off as a business expense or a net operating loss, creating credits, and by filing the appropriate tax documents, can have such documented on your transcripts issued by the Account Agency for the United States, the IRS. Once these credits are issued, you then transfer them to the state level by way of assignment, not by way of transfer. You only get one transfer for the credits, so you reserve the transfer until absolutely necessary, and just simply do what's known as an assignment of the credits. By assigning the credits, you can now focus on monetizing them. You did not pay for these credits, but you can monetize them and increase your asset and net worth value. We will be doing future videos similar to this in the future, in a conversational tone and format, to help with better education and understanding and learning. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you soon.